In Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we've been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. All who are baptized into Christ have put on Christ. Dan was baptized on May 29, 1949, at Salem Lutheran Church. In his baptism, Dan was clothed with Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, Dan will be clothed with glory. Eternal God, maker of heaven and earth, who formed us from the dust of the earth, who by your breath gave us life, we glorify you. We glorify you. Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life, who suffered death for all humanity, who rose from the grave to open the way to eternal life, we praise you.
We praise you.
Holy Spirit, author and giver of life, the comforter of all who sorrow, our sure confidence and everlasting hope, we worship you.
We worship you.
To you, O blessed Trinity, be glory and honor forever and ever. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our brother Dan. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. At this time, we pause for remembrance and an opportunity to share some memories of Dan's life. Would anyone like to speak? I've had several memories that have been shared with me over the course of this week, and I cannot begin to explain what a generous soul that Dan was. His kindness and his compassion, the way that he opened his home and made it a welcome place for everyone. The importance of that in people's lives. Being a good neighbor. Sharing tins of popcorn with neighbors around him every year at Christmas. It was an opportunity to share his love of all creation with the rest of the world. And I think often about his Sunday strolls. That time that he would take each week, whether it was a walk or a ride or a bike or a car, to just experience creation. And that routine was part of his life, and that was a blessing to each of us. We continue now with our first reading. It comes from Isaiah 43, and these are the promises that we hear on Baptism Day. But now thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We'll read Psalm 23 responsively, so I will read the regular print and ask you to respond with the bold. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
He makes me lie down in green pastures, he leads me beside
the waters. He restores my soul, he leads me in right paths for his name's sake. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Our second reading this morning comes from Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 through 17. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord. Our gospel reading today comes from John chapter 14, the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory
to you, Lord. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord. Danny J. McGee, Sr., age 74 of Fremont, died Monday, March 22nd at home. Danny was born September 24th, 1946 in Fremont to Edward and Darlene Cornell McGee. He was raised in Fremont and graduated from Fremont High School. Danny began working at Valmont in 1971 and worked there until retiring. Danny was a lifelong member of Salem Lutheran Church in Fremont. His survivors include his sons, Danny McGee of Fremont and Jason and Tanya McGee of Fremont, grandsons, Zachary and Jacob McGee, brother, Jerry and Pam McGee of Ozark, Missouri, and sister, Jamie and Rich Nissen of New York City, New York. Danny was preceded in death by his parents. Grace and peace to you from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Danny, Jason, family, and friends, what can we say on a day like today? We know in our hearts that Dan is at peace, but we will miss him. And even though we had so many years with him, nothing prepares us to say goodbye. And Dan did not teach us how to say goodbye because he was an expert at long, drawn-out goodbyes. I do not think he ever really wanted to say goodbye either. Dan loved welcoming people home. His home was his favorite place on earth, and any chance that he had to spend time there with other people was a great day. He loved the yard, the animals, and the flowers, but most of all, Dan loved the people, and the people made his house truly home. But as much as he loved his routine and his house, Dan knew that he had another home awaiting him. He knew that this life was just a journey to a better place, and that the eternal home was the one that mattered. His place in heaven was secured for him on the day of his baptism. On that day, Dan truly died. He became a new person, a child of God. On that day, that child of God is the Dan that we all grew to know and love during his life on earth. Dan's love of the Lord showed in all that he did, and that life of faith is a true comfort to each of us today. Dan was generous and kind-hearted to everyone he met. His humble service and his simple way of life provided with him with the means to show grace and generosity when others might not have been so kind. He was a good friend, a good neighbor, and an amazing dad and grandpa. Dan lived with integrity and true righteousness. We can find comfort in Proverbs 10, verse 7, when we hear, "The memory of the righteous is a blessing." Dan enjoyed the life he lived, even though it held its share of heartaches. He found joy in all kinds of music, watching people, visiting with family, friends, and neighbors. He enjoyed his coffee on the porch, feeding his squirrel friends, and watching the birds. Dan's memory is truly a blessing for all of us. Everyone who knew him has felt his thoughtfulness and his kindness. We're blessed with many memories. The memories do not teach us how to say goodbye. In our gospel reading today, Jesus is trying to do just that. He knows that his time on earth is short, and he's starting to say goodbye to his disciples. His words ring so true for us today. Do not let your hearts be troubled. And he promises us that there's a place for us with God. a dwelling place, a place where we can abide with Jesus, and a place where God abides with us, a place as welcome and beloved as the home that Dan made here on earth. But the home that Dan made here has a limitation, not in beauty or in the amount of TLC it received. Dan's home was limited because it was fixed in one place. So to experience the joy of being home, you had to go there. It was just not the same when family and friends gathered anywhere else. This is not so with the place that Jesus prepares for us. The dwelling place of God is not limited to our space and time, and we can abide with God anywhere and at any time. We do not have to go home to experience God's love. God comes to us, inviting us, gathering us together with Dan and all those who have gone before us, wherever we are. Dan understood this so well, finding God in all creation, especially during those Sunday strolls. Friends, saying goodbye is never easy, but the promise we hear from Jesus makes it possible. When we hear Jesus say, "I am the way," instead of saying goodbye, we can say, "I'll see you again someday." May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. We'll continue now with our special music, "The Old Bloody Cross." Creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, in holy baptism you have knit your chosen people together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. God of mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life in Christ. God of mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give courage and faith to all who mourn, and a sure and certain hope in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may have strength for the days ahead. God of mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. God of mercy,
hear our prayer.
Help us, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. God of mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death, our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us commend Danny Jo McGee to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Dan. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in life. Amen. Please remain silent for the tolling of the bell, once for each year of Dan's life on earth. Thank you. join the family immediately following the committal service at Christensen Field Meeting Room for a time of food and fellowship. Let us go forth in peace. In the name of Christ. Amen. Our session of music is Go Rest High on That.
I could see.